feel good inside. And brought to you in part by State Farm. It pays to double check. Talk to your agent today. Been quite a turnaround for Frank Kaminsky and his improvement in his career as a starter, going from 12.5 points a game to 16.8, five double-doubles now for Kaminsky. So what led to that change in his game?
It didn't just happen overnight. It came from all the nights I spent in the gym, all the extra time I put in after practice. And, you know, it feels good that it's been paying off so far. It'd be different, you know, if I would have put in all that time and, you know, not had as good of a season as I did last year. It's just, it's a good feeling knowing that, you know, all that hard work was for something.
And Kaminsky in the starting lineup, of course, tonight. The starting lineup's brought to you by Buffalo Wild Wings, with Kaminsky, Nigel Hayes, Sam Decker, Josh Gosser, and Trayvon Jackson for the Badgers. On the other side, Boise State, Derek Marks, Igor Hadzioomerovic, with Anthony Drimmick, Nick Duncan, and David Wacker, the starting five for the Broncos. We're 3-0, and Steven, a team that can really shoot the basketball, as we mentioned, and a team that knows how to win. They've certainly been able to pull out some victories out of the hat this year, including a double overtime win over Montana.
You know, that's a sign, Wayne, of a very veteran ball club that knows how to finish games. They've got the senior guards in Marks and Drimmick, and they know how to finish.
Boise State led by Leon Rice in his fifth season. It's been in these few years that Leon Rice has been at the helm that they have shot better than they ever had, both at the three-point range and at the free throw line.
Yeah, they will look to shoot the three early in the offensive possession, and they can dribble penetrate to draw fouls as well.
Can't say enough about Bo Ryan and what he's done in 14 seasons here in Madison.
Well, it's the system, and we've seen a number of players that came in as raw freshmen and have left as grown men that can play the game, and this team is an example of just that.
They've won 90% of their games at home under Bo Ryan, 198-21. They are 101-7 in non-conference games under Bo Ryan. They just don't lose in this building.
Yeah, it's very tough because the Grateful Red gets going, and it's a great atmosphere for college basketball.
Leon Rice has done well at Boise State. He was a longtime assistant at Gonzaga, even had the title of associate head coach while with the Zags, getting his own gig here with Boise State. As the Badgers look to stay undefeated, Boise State, for that matter, trying to stay unbeaten. Wisconsin, all the expectations of a team largely returning its core group. After last year's trip to the Final Four, the Badgers win the tip to start things off tonight.
See if the Badgers will attack off the bounce like we saw earlier in their game against Green Bay. Only five attempts from the three-point line in the first half, Wayne.
Sam Decker finding Gosser. Gosser fighting off the hand contact from Hadzioomerovic, one of three Australian natives on this Boise State club. First foul of the night goes to Hadzioomerovic.
Man, you said that easy, Wayne. That gives me hope for me the rest of the way.
Rolls right off the tongue. Wisconsin after the reset. Nigel Hayes trying to bury himself inside.
This is what Wisconsin does so well. They isolate on a wing. And nice adjustment that time by Boise State. Double team.
Hayes off that double team, getting it to Decker. Hayes can shoot the three now. Really, all of these Badgers can shoot the three. Pass it in traffic there, but it was saved for a moment by Trayvon Jackson, but he did step out of bounds right on the line. The shot clock winding down. A good defense there by Boise State.
Excellent defense, because what we saw, Hayes and Kaminsky were double teamed as soon as they got the ball.
Glenn Mayborg, Chris Beaver, and Todd Williams are officials tonight. Call Glenn Buddy. Let's see if Paul Ryan's calling him Buddy by the end of the night.
Yeah, that's a better question.
Derek Marks, one of these guards on Boise State that can pop the three from anywhere, and they will shoot it from anywhere. Marks taking it inside off the glass with the left hand, and it's Boise State on the board first, thanks to one of their two senior leading guards, Derek Marks.
Nice patience by the Broncos in the half court set. Shot clock running down, but Marks didn't panic whatsoever. Went to his left hand off the glass. Pretty move.
Marks and Drimmick, the second greatest scoring duo in Boise State history. And Sam Decker missing. And the rebound falls to the 6'10" David Wacker.
And Boise State will shoot threes in the fast break situation. So you have to, Wisconsin has to be careful not to flow back to the paint and let a trailer come free for the open look.
Tazio Maravich trying to find a way inside. Did hit the pass to Drimmick. Reset, send it back out. The shot clock inside of 10. Patience from the Boise State offense, and it's Marks with the jumper. Falling off the rim to Decker. Badgers have out-rebounded their opponents in a big way this year. Figure that to continue tonight. Not too many big bodies for Boise State. A foul there against Duncan. Boise State got on the board first, Steven.
Yeah, right here, you see Marks go left to his offhand off glass, and he made it look a lot easier than it actually is, Wayne.
Wisconsin inbounds after the foul. A couple of fouls early against the Broncos. Linsky thought about it. How many seven-footers who can put it away from there, but he's one of them.
Well, not only can he put it away from there, he can put it on the deck. He can post up. There are really no weaknesses to his game.
Off the catch and shoot. It's good.
That's what the Badgers do. If they don't hit you quickly, they can grind you in the half-court set. Very patient. They played enough with each other to know where each one likes the basketball.
Big call there against David Wacker. We take a look at the three from Gosser.
That's a nice read that time by Gosser. He was a little bit tighter on the curl. Watch here. He comes around away from the defense. Enough space to get the jumper off. Good read by Josh Gosser.
That foul's a third against Boise State. Remember the other night, Green Bay had 15 in the first half against Wisconsin. Kaminsky drains the three.
The Broncos are finding out early. You have to pick your poison against Wisconsin. You're either going to have to give up the three and cut the paint off, or, you know, you guard the three, but then you leave driving lanes open.
Kaminsky's done that quite a few times already this year. He set a career high for blocks the other night against Green Bay. We take a look at Kaminsky on the offensive end here.
A lot of times the picker gets open. So big men that are setting screens, if they set it correctly, a lot of times they free up, just like Kaminsky did that last time.
And a blocked shot on the other end from Kaminsky. He's really become a great multiplayer. He really can do it on both sides of the floor and in different ways on both sides of the floor.
Yeah, defensively, we saw him with seven blocks last game against Green Bay, a career high. Does a great job of blocking without fouling.
Take a look at our State Farm State of Success. Frank Kaminsky has had a lot of it. Career high, seven blocks against Green Bay, as you mentioned, 15 rebounds in that game, plus 25 points from Nigel Hayes. Team comes at you now with a lot of size. Ben Brust is gone, replaced in the starting lineup by a guy who was 8 inches taller than him. Nigel Hayes going to a much bigger lineup from the start.
And they're able to do that. And they have a Redwood lineup where Duye Dukin is in as well. So Jackson at the point, Sam Decker at the two at 6'9". Duye Dukin at 6'10" at the three. Hayes at 6'8" at the four. And Frank Kaminsky 7 foot at the five. So they have a lot of flexibility on this roster.
Kaminsky with 105 career blocks, fifth in Wisconsin history. It's a lot. Certainly gets up, and at 7 feet, he's an imposing figure down below. But it's one thing to be a seven-footer and stand in touch. It's another thing to use the body the way that Kaminsky can.
Well, the thing is, he doesn't get credit for his defensive prowess. You know, we hear about the 43-point game last season and what he did against Arizona in the regional final and how he can score the basketball. But defensively, very sound, very fundamental, and a lot of times without foul.
Some blood on the back of Nigel Hayes' jersey and shorts.
I think that was from Nick Duncan when he went over to the bench. They've been bleeding on the arm there. So
cleaning up the blood off the floor. Bit of a delay. Boise State will inbound. It's Mikey Thompson in the game for the first time. There's Duncan. See that left forearm, elbow area, down to the wrist even, where some splotches of blood are coming out.
It's a tough group. Now, if you look at Anthony Dremick's arm as well, he's got a couple of bruises from getting undercut in his last game. He's coming in banged up, sore back, but you're not going to keep him away from this opportunity.
You got to make sure the floor is not only wiped clean of the blood, but that it's dry after they spray that substance on the floor. Don't want anyone slipping after that. So now the towels come out to make sure the floor is dry as well. Bo Ryan's going to give it a feel. Bo might go down in the lane to see if it's all right.
Hey, he's a team player.
He's got quite a team under him as well.
Sure does. People may not know, Bo was a pretty good guard back in his day, football player as well. So
how would you know? He's got some years on you.
Oh, he's got years on me, but I'm a historian of the game, so I keep up as much as I can.
Derek Marks getting that bucket to fall. O'Ryan out of Lancaster, Pennsylvania. Although he's coached pretty much at every level at every school in this state.
Oh, sure. And this state is an underrated basketball state. The Bennett family has had a lot of success here.
Decker missing that one long, and the rebound falls to Wacker, one of the few big bodies that Boise State does have. Attacking the basket. Nice move to the hoop by Dremick.
Basket by Dremick.
The underneath layup to even the score.
See, Dremick is not a tremendous athlete, but he's so strong. He has the ability to shoot the three that you have to be honest. And once he puts it on the deck and gets his shoulder equal to yours, it'll be very difficult to keep him from the rim.
They touted Boise State's three-point shooting ability. They haven't even tried one yet.
Being quite patient right now. Just trying to take what the defense gives them.
For Frank Kaminsky. Second three so far. All nine of Wisconsin's points have come on threes.
See, the freshman, David Wacker, he's getting a study right now playing against Kaminsky.
A couple of chances to lay that one in, and he failed. Trayvon Jackson gets the rebound. Jackson going strong inside. Couldn't finish, and Dremick pulls down the board for Boise State. Screen from Wacker to the patience of the Broncos. That's something I don't think we expected to see, but taking the inside shot. Dremick couldn't get that one to fall. Good job by Wacker to punch it out. Boise State with a chance to reset on offense.
Saw Frank Kaminsky switched out on Dremick. He's still on Dremick right now. Boise State not taking advantage of it.
Trying to dribble around the perimeter, looking for a spot. A lot of size disadvantages here. Decker, 6'9", over the guard Marks. Thompson almost lost it. Shot clock down to 6. Somebody's got to put it up. Dremick charging inside against Kaminsky. And he's blocked away. Out of bounds. It will be Badger ball. Already a couple of blocks for Frank Kaminsky and a lead for the Badgers. Early lead for Wisconsin over Boise State. Before the game, Vito Brown, not only a Badger player, but a pretty good singer, too, had a chance to sing the anthem with his family.
What so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight.
Pretty good pipes.
Oh, yes. Smooth baritone there.
Entire life he's been singing with his family's group.
You can tell, too, he's got quite a presence in front of this big crowd. Because I can't carry a tune in a bucket, let alone try to sing national anthem in front of 17,000.
He's actually done it solo here before, too. Did it before an Indiana game last year at the Kohl Center. Kaminsky had that one knocked away, but it's Dukin in there for the first time. Duye Dukin taking the three. It's up off the top of the backboard, but it comes back. And it's picked up by Mikey Thompson, who's fouled. First foul against the Badgers today. Sophomore Bronson Koenig. commits the foul. All nine of Wisconsin's points have been from three-point range so far. All six from Boise State have been inside the paint.
Yeah, it's kind of interesting because you would think it would be flipped, but that's the versatility of Wisconsin. Every time Frank gets a ball on the block, it looks like Boise State's going to double along with Hayes. But Wisconsin's been patient enough to work the ball around for the open jumper on the perimeter.
First three-point attempt of the night falls for Boise State. It's Montego Alford, 5'9" junior.
Montego Alford, a tremendous athlete, change of pace guard for Leon Rice and his ball club.
Wisconsin's also been out-rebounded in this game, something they're certainly not used to so far this season. Out-rebounding their opponents by an average of 18 per game. Good job with the left hand there by Nigel Hayes.
Well, Nigel Hayes, you're going to have to double-team him because if he feels you, he spins a la James Worthy baseline style. Then he can reverse pivot, face you up, and hit the jumper. Then he can go over his left shoulder. So he's got quite a package right now, and he's feeling as confident as he's ever been.
Thompson draws the contact from Dukin. Take a look at Nigel Hayes, that footwork inside.
Watch Nigel, he feels the defense. He saw the double team coming. Duncan doesn't shut off the baseline. And a man Nigel's size to be able to move like that against defense along the baseline is something to behold.
Nigel Hayes in the starting lineup this year, he's really picked up his game on several levels, even hitting three-point shots this year, which he never did last season. Mikey Thompson at the line for Boise State, claims the first one. Some changes for the Badgers. There's Vito Brown coming in for the first time. Decker returns. Kaminsky has a seat.
Sam Decker, Trayvon Jackson.
Trayvon Jackson also back in for Wisconsin.
So now the versatility that we talked about, you'll start to see as Vito Brown comes in and Trayvon Jackson's in the backcourt for Bronson Kanan. So now Wisconsin has two primary ball handlers in the game to match up with the quickness of Alford and Thompson.
Thompson, one of two from the line, just a 59% free throw shooter so far this year. Rob Heyer in the game for the first time for Boise State, as is Desmond Trent. Nice fake out by Koenig, who drops the jumper.
Bronson Koenig is one of my favorite young players in the Big Ten right now. He really came on in the Final Four game against Kentucky. And that elevated his confidence level. He's going to be an important piece in this Wisconsin journey this season.
And 11 points in that national semifinal against the Wildcats. Desmond Trent playing for the first time this year. Left it up short. And Decker comes away with it. Decker working against Heyer. Hayes standing in the way. Decker always wants the ball. One way or the other, he's either setting somebody up or he's scoring. Nigel Hayes for three, and is. He's 4 of 6 from downtown this year.
And if you're an opposing coach, what do you do? I mean, you double him on the block. You try to double him, he spins baseline, he scores. He trails on a three-point shot and he knocks that down. There's nothing you can really do in that situation when the defense is scrambling.
Trying to fight away the contact from Koenig.
Nice job by Trayvon Jackson forcing Thompson away from the three-point line.
Shot clock winding. Thompson fights his way through and Vito Brown sends him to the free throw line. Wisconsin finding ways to score inside and outside. They move the ball around here. Guess who's open? Nigel Hayes. Earlier today at the Wisconsin shoot-around, there's a young man by the name of Jeffrey Carter, who joined the Wisconsin program today as a guest manager on the Wish Upon a Badger Foundation that they have here implemented with the Wisconsin programs. And Jeffrey, who had leukemia at age 4, got to talk to Stephen Bartle before the game. That's big time. No. Hang out with Sam Decker, Josh Gosser, Nigel Hayes. He hung out with Stephen Bartle, too. And Jeffrey from Waterloo, Wisconsin, having a great time here tonight. And a great thing that the Wisconsin basketball team has done for Jeffrey here this evening. Made him really feel a part of the group. Talked to him about the Badgers, talking about his football career that he has back at Waterloo High School. He's got a lot going on.
Yeah, he does. And you know what? It's guys like that who really appreciate being a part of this program. and how the guys responded to him. It was a pleasure getting to talk to him beforehand. We were comparing ties. He said his was much better than mine. I have to agree with him. So it was fun meeting that young man. I'm glad he's getting this opportunity.
Mikey Thompson at the free throw line for Boise State. Thompson had the first one rattled through. This one rattles out. And it's out of bounds. It'll stay with Boise State. It looks like Kaminsky was the last one to touch it.
Looked like Robin Heyer of Boise State actually got that. That's what Bo Ryan is talking to the officials about right now. But Heyer is a great story. We'll get into that a little bit later from Boise State.
Another missed rebound opportunity for Kaminsky. He and Hayes have combined for exactly zero right now, but there's the first for Kaminsky. Stay tuned for the State Farm halftime report coming up. Dave Revson, Jerry DiNardo, and Howard Griffith in this part of the season where there's a lot of football going on and a lot of hoops. Kaminsky sticks it out to Hayes, and a whistle that fouls against Rob Heyer.
Rob Heyer is a player that will mix it up. He doesn't mind getting in there. He's a senior, has played at junior college at Sheridan, Wyoming, and played at another college at Texas.
Texas Permian Basin.
Thank you. I couldn't get that out. Sat out last year and wanted to have a chance to play Division I, and he does so many good things on the floor that Coach Rice just can't keep him off.
They call him the glue guy. One didn't fall for Gosser, just rolled out. Open look to the hoop. A big possession here for Boise State. Cut it back to a one possession game. Maybe the three is what they do best. They haven't really done it much tonight. One for one in their 3-point attempts.
Badgers are sound defensively. They're closing out on open shooters quickly.
Jackson almost stole that one from Duncan. It's Drimmick for three. And it falls a little short. Sam Decker pulls down the board for Wisconsin. Jackson pushing hard, runs into Drimmick. And it's Drimmick who gets called for the foul. That's the fifth already against Boise State.
See right here, Trayvon Jackson gets ahead of steam going. And Drimmick came in with a bad back, a sore back. So I'm sure that spill right there didn't help his causes whatsoever.
Left shoulder all marked up as well.
Type of guy, senior, that Coach Rice said he's banged up, but he's not going to be able to keep him out of the game.
That pass in a no man's land, but Jackson saves it to Decker.
Great awareness by Trayvon Jackson to get to that loose ball.
That's stealing 2 points right there. What could have been a turnover. Good job by Trayvon Jackson. Move to the hoop by Heyer, trying to go over Kaminsky. It's not easy. It's out of bounds. It will be Badger ball. Last touched by Derek Marks. A 9-2 run for the Badgers and a great play here by Jackson feeding Sam Decker.
Great job by Trayvon with his awareness of the ball and where it was. Being able to beat two Broncos that were closer to the ball. He beat them for that 50-50 ball. That's what a lot of times, Wayne, can be the difference between a win and a loss. A couple of those plays right there.
Already his fourth assist tonight as Kaminsky touches one off the glass. Biggest lead so far for the Badgers, an 11-2 run. It's the type of thing that Boise State needs to stop immediately. They don't want this to keep going. Haven't had a field goal in a while. They won't have one here. This one out of bounds against Wacker. It's been almost 5 minutes since Boise State last made a basket.
See, David Wacker, the freshman center, he's going to be a good one, but he's got to understand at this level, there's contact that's not called, especially in the paint area. When that ball comes to you, you better have vice grips to hold the rock.
Long J from Kaminsky. Just a beautiful touch on the shot. 10 points so far for the big man. And Boise State needs a timeout. A 13-2 run for the Badgers, highlighted by Kaminsky.
Watch how efficient Wisconsin is, even with their bigs. As they have this play here. Okay, that was the one I was thinking was another one, Wayne, but Frank does a great job of facing up the defense, assessing quickly. He's never in a hurry. And Wacker that time was too far back for him to contest the jump.
A lot of teams you identify bigs because there's only a couple. Wisconsin, it seems like saying bigs is kind of a given. Everybody's big out there for them.
Yeah, just ask Boise State.
Koenig pulls down the rebound. 13-15 on the clock. The last time Boise State had a shot to drop. Badgers doing a good job capitalizing in the meantime. Frank Kaminsky already with 10 points tonight. Badgers shooting 9 of 14 from the field. Open look for Koenig. Ball's a little short. Decker fighting for the rebound. Dukin as well. They lost it. Thompson grabs it. Broncos need a bucket. Maybe Mikey Thompson has it. He does.
Rare time when the Badgers don't get back defensively with good communication. Nice job by the Broncos spreading the floor. We talked about it. They'll shoot a three early in the possession. The defense is not set.
So many stars on this Badger roster. Nobody's really prepared to have a breakout season. When you look at Bronson Koenig, he's maybe the one guy on this team that could break out from last year to this year.
I think he and Duye Dukin can as well. Duye Dukin is now 6'10". And really works hard on his game. A really good stretch four. But he's got the physicality now to bang down low as well.
Kevin Allen with the left hand. It's that one to flow home. 6'11". We'll see if he can get out there and bang bodies with some of these bigger Badger players.
Kevin Allen ain't scared. He's Detroit, Michigan native, and he likes the big spotlight.
Dukin got wrapped up with Allen. There you go. Allen getting physical on the floor, trying to keep Boise State around. BTN basketball certainly is here, and tomorrow night the Buckeyes play host to Sacred Heart. Then on Monday, the Spartans take on Santa Clara in a non-conference matchup in East Lansing. Coverage starts at 7 Eastern, presented by April Air on BTN and BTN2Go. 22-16, Wisconsin has the lead here over Boise State. Broncos shooting just 33% from the field. That's right where they were in their double overtime win the other night against Montana. The lowest shooting output they've ever had in a win under Leon Rice. They don't win too many games at 33%.
No, but what you're starting to see is a Boise State team that's playing much better defense than they did the last two seasons. They're in the 200 rank in terms of field goal percentage, defense, and scoring. So Leon Rice trying to establish a toughness on the defensive end for the Broncos.
They're also out-rebounding Wisconsin 13-8 tonight. Foul there as Koenig reached in, grabbed Derek Marks.
The Wisconsin foul.
Fourth foul against Wisconsin. Second against Koenig. Trayvon Jackson will come in, give Koenig a rest. Koenig's gotten some decent amount of minutes here tonight, coming off the bench, sophomore.
One of the things that we noticed here early on, Wisconsin, their last game, had 37 free throw attempts. They were 24 for 37 versus Green Bay. They have not gotten to the line yet here in the first half.
Drimmick trying to carry it inside. It looks like both teams are sort of out of their rhythm tonight. Maybe because the defense has been so good on both sides.
I think that's a lot, has a lot to do with it.
Out of bounds here. It stays with the Broncos. 15 on the shot clock.
And you see Frank Kaminsky sitting down defensively against Drimmick, one of the better guards in the country. I know Drimmick is not 100%, but he can still score. 29 in his last game versus Montana, and Frank taking the challenge head on.
Because of those nagging injuries, Drimmick has not shot very well this year. It's Marks going up inside over Kaminsky.
That's by Marks.
Marks, all Mountain West honorable mention last year. He has 6 points.
Derek Marks is honorable mention Mountain West. I'd like to see maybe three or four guards that are better.
The three falls for Kaminsky again. He's been red hot behind the arc tonight. 13 for Kaminsky. Three threes.
See, what people don't realize, Wayne, and the Boise State coaching staff is really upset with Kevin Allen right there because he didn't get out defensively. Big men don't like leaving the paint defensively. That's why Frank Kaminsky is so effective, because typically centers, they don't want to come out on the three-point line and guard there.
That one was tipped. Gosser got a hand on it. What a great defensive players in all the Big Ten. Nigel Hayes thought about that three, carries it inside. Weak side pass to Dukin, and it falls through.
That's just excellent playmaking by Nigel Hayes that time. Looked like he was going to shoot the basketball, gave it up at the right time.
And now a steal for Hayes. He led the team in steals a year ago. Nice pass by Jackson, the touch pass to Dukin. Kaminsky cleans it up off the glass. Jackson fouling Marks back on the other end quickly, almost took one away. As Trayvon Jackson and the Badgers hustling to get to the basket tonight. Kaminsky and Wisconsin's opened up an 11-point lead. The star power of the Badgers, Steven, these two tonight are perfect.
Yeah, they're just taking what the defense gives them. They're not forcing any shots. The ball movement is excellent. And Frank Kaminsky is putting on a clinic here, especially against David Wacker. Going to be a talented freshman center, but he's a freshman. And he's getting schooled right here by Frank Kaminsky. No box out. Frank getting right to the rim on a nice follow-up.
15 points for Kaminsky and 6 of 6. Nigel Hayes has 5. These two will be a big part of the reason why the Badgers continue to succeed, not only in the Big Ten, but nationally, all the way to the Final Four last year, and they haven't lost much from that team. Alfred tucks it and goes up. And Decker fights for the rebound. A lot of size for the Badgers. Boise State has rebounded well tonight. It's tough to sustain that against this Wisconsin team.
They made an effort to get to the glass.
Hayes was fouled on the floor. It'll be a one in the bonus, 17th foul against Boise State. It's against Wacker, his second. Bo Ryan, opposite of Leon Rice. Coach Ryan, 6 times to the Sweet 16. They've been to the NCAA tournament every year he's been here. Last year, that first trip to the Final Four. Nigel Hayes, big part of that. Nails the first one. You know what Nigel calls Bo Ryan?
What's that?
Calls him Dad. Calls him Pops.
Yeah, well, tell you what, he knows. Nigel Hayes is a smart young man. He knows what he's doing when he calls Pops or Dad. Trust me.
Said it came at a time last year when they were losing a bunch of games and kind of made the team laugh a little bit. From that point on, Wisconsin rolled. They were all the way to the Final Four. He thinks it was the turning point of their season.
It could have been. I mean, this is a very loose group. They take care of business. They don't mind having fun.
Trimmick carries it inside.
Derek Marks is really being patient right now, but he can take over the game.
Free throw line there. He missed it. The rebound to Trayvon Jackson. Jackson can do a little bit of everything on the floor. Lost the ball there, but fighting for it for a moment. Boise State picks it up. It's Alford trying to go up, climbing on Kaminsky's back, almost literally. As it goes out of bounds, it will stay with Boise State. Join us at the half for the State Farm Halftime Report. Dave Repson, Jerry DiNardo, and Howard Griffin. A lot to talk about, a big day in both college football and college basketball. Saw Nebraska get upset today by Rhode Island in basketball.
You know, a lot of times, shot blockers don't get credit for altering shots. Alfred tried to go in one-on-one against Kaminsky. Wasn't even trying to go for the layup, was trying to draw the contact. And Boise State fortunate, Wacker was able to get that to go.
Wacker with the turnaround jumper. Alfred is only 5'9". Kaminsky at 7 feet. Decker sends it out. Kaminsky's open again. Hasn't missed a shot yet. Defense closed quickly, and now Decker rolls over Drinick, and the offensive foul called against Decker.
See Drinick kind of hold his back a little bit. Man, this guy is tough. He's gutting it out. Put his body in harm's way that time. he guessed right on which way Decker was going.
Wisconsin has matched their biggest lead so far. Boise State trying to hang around. Three-pointers haven't been there yet. Long two for Marks. Broncos just 2 of 4 from three-point range in this game. That's really their bread and butter.
Derek Marks is a player who dropped 30 in the second half at Creighton 2 seasons ago. Gave them 38 in the Quest Center. So this is a young man that can take over for Boise State. He's being patient right now. Has scored 60% of his points in the second half in his career.
Look at Kaminsky, the beautiful move inside, the turnaround jumper. Fantastic finish there by Frank Kaminsky.
I'm telling you, Wayne, you better start talking about Frank's mama or something. Grab his shorts, step on his feet. You better try to get in his head because he is in a rhythm right now. If you don't bother him or deny him the basketball, he's going to hurt you all night.
17 points, 7 of 7 from the field. His mom was a college volleyball player. She can handle it.
Oh, she can handle it. Your dad can handle it, too. His dad was a baller as well.
Marks with a hand in his face. Couldn't get that one to fall. Just rimmed out. Looked good off the hand of Marks. Able to grab that one. Now Wisconsin looking for its biggest lead. Duye Dukin gives it to him.
Notice now this Redwood lineup, Josh Gosser is running the point. Not Trayvon Jackson or Bronson Koenig. So this huge lineup is on the floor right now with Gosser at the point.
Marks finds a way to get to the hoop anyway. You called it the Redwood lineup earlier. And a timeout on the floor is called by Boise State. Ryan with Fitz, even though his team up. Frank Kaminsky, you can't say enough about the way he has played so far in this first half. 17 points, 7 of 7 from the field. 3 threes, the guy's done it all.
Well, he's done it all, and that last shot was so pretty. He just left his baby pinky toe and just faded back away from the deep mid. I mean, that's a 7-footer doing that. He is fun to watch.
Shot clock is off. Last possession for the Badgers in this first half. Trayvon Jackson trying to make it happen. The jump shot from 15 for Jackson. That's a 14-point Badger lead.
That's too easy. A 15-foot uncontested jumper at the end of the half. Wisconsin cutting them up.
Alford couldn't get that shot off to end the first half, but a pretty good one for Wisconsin. At halftime here in Madison, everything looking good for the Badgers. A 38-24 lead over Boise State. Stay tuned next for the State Farm Halftime Report from Chicago and Madison. Wisconsin a 38-24 lead over Boise State, looking for a 4-0 start before they head off to the Bahamas. They're going on a little trip. The battle for Atlantis is coming up throughout Thanksgiving weekend. Frank Kaminsky 17 points in the first half. Bo Ryan saw his team shoot 62.5% from the field in the first half.
And that's a lot of skill, but a lot of sharing the basketball and taking what's given to you, not forcing the issue.
The assist to turnover ratio number a lot as Duncan puts down the three. 7 assists in the first half for the Badgers, 3 turnovers.
Beautiful scripted play to come out in the second half to get a three from Nick Duncan. Excellent execution by the Broncos.
Boise State's going to need more of that in the second half of this game. Didn't take many threes in the first half. What do you think took that away from their game?
Wisconsin.
Not too many teams in this country that have big players who have that soft of a touch on their jump shot.
You're right. And to go back to your point, Boise State averages 22 threes a game. They were 2 of 5 in the first half. Now they're 3 of 6. Wisconsin only allowed almost 5 threes per game against Big Ten opponents. They're the best in the Big Ten at defending the three. So they're doing an excellent job of continuing that trend against a very good shooting Broncos ball club.
Hadzi Omerovic was fouled by Josh Gosser, so he'll go to the free throw line.
Look at Nigel Hayes here on the perimeter. Sizes it up, puts it on the deck, stop, pop. You know, he's got so much to his game that we're just starting to see, Wayne. You know, we thought he was just a post-up guy, a face-up jump shooter. He has put in mad work in the summer, and it's really showing right now.
Big Ten Sixth Man of the Year Award last year, Big Ten All-Freshman Team. Putting up threes this year. He's at 4 3-pointers so far. Didn't hit any last season. Hadzi Omerovic drains both of his free throws out of the Australian Institute of Sport.
Which seems like it supplied half the players on the West Coast in the West Coast Conference, the Mountain West Conference, in Pac-12.
It supplied three to Boise State. Hadzi Omerovic, just one of them. Anthony Grimmick another. And Nick Duncan the other. And on the back of Hayes there is Duncan, who commits the foul. That's his second. Team's first in the second half.
See, the thing is, when you look at Wisconsin on film as an opposing team, they look good. But boy, when you see them in person, Nigel Hayes' first step is as good as any forward in the Big Ten. Very quick, very strong, and always under control.
Inbound pass goes all the way to the backcourt. The Badgers some room to set up their offense. Jackson runs into a double team and sends it back out. Decker fights his way down low around Grimmick for the basket.
The floor spacing right there allowed Sam Decker to receive a post feed, and there was no help defense on the other side. Wisconsin doing an excellent job of lifting defenders from the offside.
Another rebound for Kaminsky, just 4 points for Decker so far. He's averaged 17 a game. Decker Hayes, look at Nigel Hayes, wide open for the dunk. Boise State needs a timeout. And the Badgers rolling at home.
Based on plays similar to this, Wayne, look at the floor spacing. There's no help side defense right here. The pass goes in. Dermott goes for the steal, doesn't get it. The floor spacing allows Sam Decker an easy, easy layup. And the reason being, Frank Kaminsky and Trayvon Jackson are on the weak side. Everybody can shoot threes, so you have to stay home. And that allows for plays like that to happen.
So many threats on this Badger team. They've made 15 of their last 20 shots tonight. Biggest lead yet for Wisconsin is 15. He's trying to cut into it. You see it pulled out his shot too often. Thinking about it here, thinking about it, trying to go up over Jackson. You mentioned how that Wisconsin defense just takes away the three. Really getting into the mind of March there. Shot clock down to one. And Marks had to put it up from long distance, couldn't get it. Fighting with Decker for the rebound.
Goodness.
A big collision. They both seem to be okay. Decker up quickly.
I don't think Marks is okay. Marks slammed his head. That's not good right there. I mean, these are tough guys, but boy, both of them popped their head on the floor. Watch the collision. Watch Derek Marks' head right there. I mean, that's the makings of a concussion. Yep. I'm sure they're going to, looks like they're going to keep him in the game, but gotta be careful here.
That was a big collision. Two guys running at full speed for the ball. Don't see collisions like that too much in this game. Mark seems to be okay, staying in there for now. And Decker also in there for Wisconsin. Taking the cobwebs out a little bit. At least they didn't collide head-to-head. It seemed like they're pretty much body-to-body contact there, chest-to-chest. Legs got tangled a little bit. Could have been a lot worse.
No doubt about it. And it's a good thing that Coach Ryan is, I think, asking to see. He starts smiling. I think he's asking something about a foul, but they were like, hey, no call. Play on.
basket for Drimmick, working against Jackson, someone his own size. Kaminsky's there too, but Drimmick drops it in.
Drimmick did an excellent job of waving David Wacker out of the way. Wacker was coming into that area. He waved him away, knew he had a height advantage over Jackson, and was able to convert.
You were here the other night against Green Bay, and the Badgers won. Kaminsky, Hayes, and Decker outscored the entire Green Bay team that night. They're doing it again tonight. Trayvon Jackson with the bucket there, but Kaminsky, Hayes, and Decker, 32 points. Boise State, 31.
Well, when you can shoot threes, you can post up, and you're unselfish, good things happen.
Kaminsky with the defense over Thompson. Now Nigel Hayes running the offense for the Badgers. Johnson shooting 68% from the field tonight.
Sam Decker missed Hayes on the block. He had Drimmick posted up. Now take one dribble to the right, improve your angle, and feed the post.
Frank Kaminsky finally misses. First time he's missed all night. Marks gets the rebound. Boise State looking for a shot. Marks takes it. Way off, though, and Kaminsky pulls down another board. Fourth rebound for Kaminsky tonight. Badgers slowing the tempo down a little bit in this second half. Cross court to Nigel Hayes. He puts up the tray. A little short. Marks pulls it down.
I'm really seeing Boise State look for that three quick in the offense like we thought we would. Wisconsin's done a really good job getting back defensively.
Thompson gets the basket to count. He'll go to the free throw line. After a timeout on the floor, the foul on Decker. Boise State trying to cut into the Wisconsin lead. He's on Wisconsin radio tonight.
Yeah, he's a big basketball fan. He's very knowledgeable. Follows the team when he can. He'll be in the Bahamas doing radio as well. I said, you're going to play when you're down? He said, no, I'm studying tape, man. I gotta stay up on my research.
Steve Stricker's a season ticket holder here. Right in the front row, courtside, behind the basket.
Yeah, Steve Stricker, a fellow Illini, proud Illini. Doing an excellent job on the PGA Tour.
Looks like he's shredded in his colors, though.
Well, he's a Madison native, so he's got that right. He can be proud of where Wisconsin colors all he wants.
Thompson from the free throw line, missing that one. It's knocked away from Vito Brown. Out of bounds to Wisconsin. Not too many turnovers in this game, just three on each side.
He's done a good job there. Mikey Thompson, once again, having an opportunity. He's a little mad at himself for not making his free throw attempts, knowing that they're so crucial and trying to cut into this lead.
It's actually a foul against Boise State. Second team foul in this second half. James Webb, the third, who hasn't seen any action until now. Webb with his first foul. Defense there by Duncan, forcing Hayes to get rid of it. Shot clock winding down. It's at six as Koenig drains the three.
I just looked at the bench over at Boise State to the coaching staff, and they're shaking their head and rubbing their forehead. Because it was just good. It was great defensive sequence for the Broncos. Last 6 seconds of contested three, but it goes down.
Biggest lead for Wisconsin, now 16 as Montego Alford cuts into it. How about Koenig, 2013 Wisconsin High School Player of the Year? One thing Bo Ryan does well is recruit in this state.
He understands what he wants out of his system. They develop players very well. And they've got John Luer, who had a big night the other night for Memphis Grizzlies. And Stiesma, they've got some players that have had success in the NBA level.
After a turnover, Boise State gives it right back.
Well, right here, Montego Alford, you can't be in much better defensive position. That's just a better shot. Bronson Koenig sizes him up, knows he's got a height advantage, elevates beautifully for the three.
Koenig, Gosser, Decker, all from right here in the state of Wisconsin. good to keep those players at home. It's good to develop that talent. So more guys from this area want to come play for Bo Ryan.
Foster going down to get that and promptly calls a timeout.
We'll take one as well, Bo Ryan. Happy with that effort. Happy with this lead over Boise State. Wisconsin, the lead over Boise State. Perfect sevens there for football scores, right? Penn State losing to Illinois today. The Illini pulling out the 16-14 win. Buckeyes keep rolling. Minnesota's win over Nebraska, plus Wisconsin's win over Iowa. Hit them next week. They're playing each other anyway, but it's going to be for the Big Ten West Championship and a spot in the Big Ten Championship game against Ohio State. So big one next week. You can watch that right here on BTN.
Yeah, there's no love loss between Wisconsin and Minnesota. Believe me on that one.
Axe will be on the line next week as Gosser gets the rebound after that missed three. Played for a lot more than the Axe next week, though. Minnesota, not sure many people expected them to have a shot at the Big Ten Championship game, but a win next week, Camp Randall will get him there.
Jerry Kill's done an outstanding job of rebuilding that program in a relatively short amount of time.
Nigel Hayes sticks it in the rim. You ever do that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, if you're a basketball player, everybody's done that once. And he's going to smile about it, but believe me, his teammates will encourage him to take the next one. That's all right. That happens sometimes. You know, Nigel Hayes talked about waking up super early, listening to a motivational speech by Eric Thomas, who is this generation's Les Brown or Zig Ziglar. And it really got his mindset going to get in the gym and shoot 700 jumpers a day, work on his ball handling. And we're starting to see the benefits of it right now. But very conscientious young man and understood what it takes to be great.
Trayvon Jackson from downtown.
Man, Trayvon Jackson just playing within himself. Doesn't have to press at all. He can take his and choose his spots. It's a fun team to watch.
Eighth triple for Wisconsin, shooting 47% from behind the arc. Mikey Thompson is fouled by Gosser. Another timeout on the floor. Things looking good for the Badger offense. Shaping up to be another exciting basketball season in the Big Ten, and tomorrow night's Buckeyes play host to Sacred Heart, and on Monday the Spartans take on Santa Clara in a non-conference matchup in East Lansing. Coverage starts at 7 Eastern, presented by April Air on BTN and BTN to go.
Really looking forward to watching Ohio State freshman D'Angelo Russell. It's a very efficient scorer, even though he's just a freshman. I think he just had a chance to lead the conference in scoring.
Mark's kind of slipped there as he's called for a travel. Some good young players in this conference. Cameron Chapman of Michigan stands out. Freshman is getting some starting time there for the Wolverines.
Yeah, he's one of those players at 6'7", multi-skilled, can play a number of different positions that Beeline loves.
See many freshmen on this Wisconsin team. It's an older group that's trying to win now. This is a big year for them. Three senior starters, plus Decker, who's a junior, and could be headed to the next level. Trayvon Jackson, a senior, a leader on this team. He's had a good night.
The use of change of pace on the dribble, the cheapest dribble, really nice.
9 points for Jackson tonight. Wisconsin's opened up. Big lead in this second half. Decker with a spin move. B.A. Dukin thought about it. Kaminsky spins inside. Hits his own rebound, and the putback goes.
And Kevin Allen did a pretty good job of closing out on the three, but you got a guy who can spin like that, get his own rebound. It's tough to defend.
Jackson to the hoop. Trey
Trayvon Jackson in double digits, and Wisconsin running away. A 23-point lead for the Badgers.
Well, you see, Frank, the tank, doesn't give up on the play, gets his own rebound, Wayne, it goes off the glass. And then Trayvon Jackson says, I'll just go with my right hand on the layup. We're going to beat you back on offense. Those two having a fun time here in the second half.
Jackson in double figures. Kaminsky has 19. Badgers with their biggest lead yet. Up 23. They've really shut down the Boise State offense in this second half. Drimmick finally makes it three. Marks and Drimmick combined for 256 career three-pointers. That's the first from either one of them tonight.
And even that one was contested. He had a hand up on it. He just was set, had the puppy set correctly and let it fly.
It's 14 points in the second half for Boise State. Kaminsky, another spin move and a floater falls.
You know why that's so good, Wayne? Is because Frank Kaminsky understands big men, if you get them moving in one direction, it's very difficult for them to change directions defensively in that sequence. So that's why you're starting to see the spin move. Kevin Allen, the big man, trying to stay up. Watch it here. He starts, goes left hard. You see Kevin Allen doing a pretty good job defensively, but Frank under control, knowing that the big fellow is not going to be able to keep up with him on the spin to free himself for the baby shot. Baby hook.
Ninth career 20-point game for Kaminsky. Not sure he'll get the career high tonight, that 43-pointer last year against North Dakota State, or the North Dakota still standing out. Decker working against Heyer, turns it over. Drimmick got in front of the pass. Boise State's offense still trying to find their groove. Marks for three.
Marks trying to put on a good performance for the 17 family members that drove up to Madison from Plainfield, Illinois, where he's from. See if he can ignite a little run for the Broncos here.
Marks out of Plainfield Central High School. 13 points tonight, a new season high. It's like all the Chicago suburban kids says he's from Chicago, but he's really not. Nigel Hayes goes up to the basket. He'll go to the free throw line.
Nice pass right there behind the back, away from the defense. Nigel a little upset with himself that he wasn't able to finish that one.
And at the line for the Badgers.
You saw right there Bronson Koenig with the offhand, on the move, bounce pass right to Nigel Hayes.
Averaging 15 points per game so far this year, 12 tonight. Turpin comes back in as Decker has the seat. Nigel Hayes, the talented sophomore. Family full of Buckeyes fans.
Buckeyes actually recruited him late. Kind of late, but he kept his commitment to Wisconsin. I'm sure he's glad about that decision.
Yeah, he said it wasn't a hard one, and he doesn't regret it. Marks, who lost his footing for a moment, but kept his dribble. Nigel Hayes trying to poke it away. Will stay with Boise State, though, as Nigel pleads his case.
You gotta love that young man up there.
He's a little more animated than Buff.
Oh, yeah, for sure. That's probably why they get along so well.
Trayvon Jackson having a seat. Sam Decker as well. A little rest for these Badgers. Into the game tonight. Monday morning, they go to the Bahamas. Jeffrey Carter's having the time of his life tonight. They visited Jeffrey as a team, the basketball team did, when he was 4 years old. He was diagnosed with leukemia. He was in the hospital. The Wisconsin basketball team visited him at that point. He's been a lifelong Badger fan ever since, and he's living the dream tonight here in Madison. Mike Thompson hits the jumper. What a story. Jeffrey having a great time tonight.
Jeffrey's a fan of good basketball, so that he's in the right place for that.
You should have seen him at the shoot-around. He was making the jumpers from about the free throw line even deeper.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the blood gets pumping here in the Kohler Center if you haven't been in here and had a chance to play.
Bronson Koenig hits the jumper as well.
I'm telling you, he's going to be the next star here in Wisconsin. Just a solid handle to shoot the rock. Has got good size from the point guard position.
Rainbow doesn't go down from Marks. Duye Dukin from the corner, too strong. Nasser couldn't get it to fall down. With a nice pass. Wacker couldn't finish, though. What a tough night for Wacker. Kaminsky's going up strong. Frank Kaminsky has been a monster from three-point range. The long jumpers have fallen. And this time, going all the way to the rack. Basketball on BTN is presented by April Air. Feel good inside. And brought to you in part by State Farm. It pays to double check. Talk to your agent today.
Well, when we look at the stat sheet, Sam Decker's got four attempts. Josh Gossett with four attempts. And yet, they're up 23. So these guys are going to have to understand that some night it's going to be Trayvon Jackson's night. Another night it's going to be Hayes's night. And these guys are going to have to share the spotlight. They haven't had a problem with it yet. It's the only thing I can see that might derail this ball club is that they don't stick together. But they haven't had a problem doing that thus far.
You see any chink in the armor there where that could happen?
No. These guys, they respect each other. They're a very close-knit group. I don't see it happen.
Duye Dukin, too strong. Rebound to Drimmick. Kaminsky tonight, 10 of 12. Hayes, 4 of 6. Jackson, 5 of 6. Koenig, 3 for 4 off the bench. Wisconsin shooting 62%. Hayes ends up fighting for the rebound with Kaminsky, but a foul against Webb. It's his second, team 6th.
Looks like Boise State only sending one to the offensive glass, so they were having a little success with that in the beginning of the game, but now just trying to get back defensively to stop the fast break.
From a Boise State perspective tonight, you come here, you've won your first three games, you come here to Madison, you get it handed to you a little bit. What is the takeaway for the Broncos and for Leon Rice?
Well, a lot of times for Leon Rice, when he's trying to get his point across and the team is 3-0, sometimes players don't want to listen as well as they possibly can.
Nasser couldn't get the put back.
So when you lose a game like this, even to the number three team in the country, you get the players' attention a little bit better in film session.
Marks strains the three, his second of the second half. Now 16 for Marks, adding to his season high.
Derek Marks worked really hard on that jump shot. Product of the Chicago Bulls training academy coming up under the tutelage of Larry Stewart. So he's a young man and has put a lot of work into his game.
D.A. Dukin trying another three. Not quite gotten those to fall tonight. One of the few tough shooting nights belongs to Dukin, who's 1 for 6 from three-point range. Duncan nice hit a three earlier. And Nigel Hayes comes away with the ball.
Nick Duncan had a wide open look and Nigel closed out beautifully under control.
Open look for Gosser. He can't get it to fall. Webb leaps high for the rebound. A steal by Dukin, but he turns it right back over trying to save it. Oh, Simpson will go to the free throw line after that foul from Gosser. It's the fifth in this second half for Wisconsin. The third against Gosser.
Well, Dukin almost came up with the steal and was just trying to throw it while he was still in bounds. Mikey Thompson has been pretty impressive here. He's gotten to the rim at will. One of the few players that has been able to break down the Wisconsin defenders off the bounce.
Thompson trying to get into double figures tonight. Vito Brown comes back in. Koenig returns well. Dukin and Gosser will come out. 7 points tonight for Koenig, a new season high for him.
Bronson Koenig was boxing out a few minutes ago and came up a little stiff with that lower back. That's the beautiful thing about being 18 to 22 years old. Something like that happens, you can bounce right back. If something like that happened to me, I'd be in traction for a week.
Mikey Thompson now with 10 points. Myers, you can still play, I think.
No. I tried, believe me. And the knees in the back said, no, sir. The mind remembers, but the body forgets quickly.
Badger defense has been stifling so far this season, averaging just 45 points allowed per game in the first three. 47 tonight against a very good shooting team. Rick Kaminsky puts it up from downtown. 26 for Kaminsky.
It's one thing to be 7 foot. It's another thing to be 7 foot with a quick release. He gets it in the shooting pocket so quickly and lets it go. It's impossible to stop.
Jackson trying to save it, but it's out of bounds. It will stay with Boise State. 26 points for Frank Kaminsky and a big lead for the Badgers. One of the great things about Wisconsin athletics, the Wish Upon a Badger program, and Jeffrey Carter, tonight's Culligan pure and simple difference maker out of Waterloo, Wisconsin. Jeffrey Carter hanging out with the boys earlier today. Guest manager for tonight's game. Some hugs from Sam Decker. Talking hoops with Nigel Hayes. And an autograph, too.
Sure.
Kaminsky as well. I know he talked to you, too.
Yeah, it was fun meeting Jeffrey and comparing ties. This is a lot better than mine, but it's really special, and it's good for these student athletes to understand the impact they have on others' lives. They may not understand just by putting on a jersey, but they come out and they represent a whole program, a whole state. Being the state university here in Wisconsin means a lot to a lot of people, including Jeffrey.
Nigel Hayes was held by Chandler Hutchison.
Words
of wisdom from Jeffrey to Nigel before the game today. Nigel trying to get him to go to the Bahamas with them.
I tell you what, if they keep playing like this, they might find a ticket here.
Johanstad enters for the first time for Boise State. We'll have the final drive for you on BTN coming up after this ball game. Zach Showalter, Germantown, Wisconsin native, enters for the first time for the Badgers. Zach's dad played with Bo Ryan at UW-Platteville. Nigel Hayes at the stripe. Big night for him. 13 points. We'll get one more from the line after making that free throw. Bonus time, the 17th foul against Boise State. Hayes from the free throw line last year, just 58.5%. 5-for-5 tonight, now 6-for-6.
Jordan Smith
comes in for Wisconsin. Emptying the bench a little bit here in the final minutes. Frank Kaminsky comes out. 26 for Kaminsky tonight, 11 of 13. He had 3 blocks, 5 rebounds. Another complete night from the senior big man. Boise State trying to finish strong. Montego Alford.
You can see the athleticism from Alford. Just the elevation on the jumper alone.
He's 5'9". You 6'5 guards, you don't understand that.
Not like that.
Chandler Hutchison charges into Hayes. That's something in a 24-point game, final minutes. Nigel Hayes standing strong in the paint, drawing a charge.
Yeah, well, that's, you know, they, Wisconsin is really playing against themselves. And what I mean by that, when you're the number three team in the country, there's not going to be a lot of nights at home in the non-conference slate where you're going to get pushed. And so they've really done a great job against Boise State. But just because they're up 20-plus points doesn't mean they're going to abandon their principles. They're going to keep continuing to do what they need to do, which is be on the floor.
Well, Bo Ryan got Hayes out of there pretty quickly after he did hit the deck in a 24-point game. Vito Brown connects from long distance. He can sing and he can shoot.
Yeah, he's a strong young man. You'll start to see his maturation. As long as he puts the work in the gym, you'll start to see him improve like all the other forwards that have come through here.
That was a long two for Brown. Had a toe on the line. Vito and his family band, Shades of Brown, sang the national anthem before the game tonight. Chandler Hutchison goes around with the left hand.
Passed by Hutchison.
Chandler Hutchison is going to be a future player here with the Broncos. Kind of a late bloomer in California. A lot of upside.
A long three from Riley Deering. First career bucket for Deering.
And the Badgers, Matt Harris.
Riley Deering shot this from Milwaukee. Got some range on that jumper.
For Webb.
Redshirt last year, put on about 10 pounds between then and now. His dad was a D1 ball player at Virginia. Darren Deering. Hutchison with the good moves. Lost the ball. Now it's picked up by Showalter. The final drive coming up after this one. It's been a successful night for the Badgers. Jordan Smith. A little short. And another chance here. Showalter. Short again. The team's fighting hard for the ball, but it's Alford who picks it up for Boise State. Alford's got some moxie. Desmond Trent has the basket.
As this game closes out, 1 minute remaining. Wisconsin heading down to the Bahamas where they'll play UAB the first game in the winter, Florida, Georgetown, also North Carolina, UCLA, and Oklahoma in that tournament. In my opinion, that's replaced Maui Invitational as the best tournament around Thanksgiving.
It should be a good tournament down in Paradise Island. Nice ball movement inside, and Deering with the finish. The future of this Wisconsin program looking good here in the final minutes.
You'd like to see these guys get a chance to play because they work just as hard as the starters and the stars on the squad. And without them, Wisconsin wouldn't be as successful as they are.
Desmond Trent scored the last 5 points for Boise State. And wrapping it up here in Madison tonight, the third-ranked Badgers still undefeated. A 4-0 start to this season and a bigger test tonight. They certainly were up to it.
Yeah, this is a quality opponent from a quality league. So the Broncos will be heard from before it's all said and done.
Wisconsin now 4-0, a 78-54 victory tonight over Boise State. Jeffrey Carter goes home happy tonight. A big game for the Badgers all the way around. And Wisconsin still undefeated. That will do it tonight for Madison. The final score, 78-54. The Badgers win. For Stephen Barno, I'm Wayne Randazzo. This has been the presentation of the Big Ten Network. Again, the final, 78-54, Wisconsin. Coming up next, the final drive.